graduates, administration, faculty members, friends and families of the graduates, thank you for the honor of being allowed to address you this evening. You know, before I even started working on this speech, I had some friends offer me some advice on how to handle this situation. The advice I can't get out of my head right now is, hey, what's the worst thing that could happen? Except you dookie, passing out, and falling off the stage. So if you don't mind, I plan to stand here and hang on to this podium for dear life. Because frankly, I'm about as tense as a moose's behind during gnat season. Recently, I heard a story about President Calvin Coolidge, an introvert after my own heart. At dinner, a guest sitting next to him said, I have a bet with my husband that I can get you to say more than three words to me. To which Calvin Coolidge coolly replied, you lose. I think most people who know me would probably describe me a little bit like the 30th President of the United States. A man of few words, avoiding crowds, avoiding social events, the first guy out the door after church. In fact, I'm sure some of you are actually attending tonight just to hear me say more than three words in a row. I'll try to honor that reputation by keeping my speech short. I know my mission this evening is to utter some profound words of wisdom, which most likely very few of you will remember 10 minutes after this ceremony is over. And I guess that's okay, because seniors, this night's about you. It's about celebrating your accomplishments as well as your bright hope for the future. Speaking of the senior class, to the members of the senior class who are responsible for me standing up here tonight, and the panic attack I'm experiencing right now, I want you to consider this. I have a particular set of skills. Skills I have acquired over a very long career. Skills that make me a nightmare for people like you. Humble and kind. A song made famous by Tim McGraw was written by a woman named Lori McKenna. She wrote it to her five children, conveying the important advice she wanted them to remember regarding character. When you look around the world today, it becomes painfully obvious that there is too much arrogance and meanness out there. Being humble and kind is often seen as a weakness, but in reality, it's the complete opposite. Some of the toughest people I know are also some of the most humble and kind people I know. And I've been blessed to have many such people in my life. A prime example, and one of my inspirations, would be my father. A Korean War veteran, a Hell's Canyon cowboy, a rancher, a farmer, soft-spoken, kind-hearted, God-fearing, and tougher than nails. C.S. Lewis once said, being humble is not thinking less of yourself, it's thinking of yourself less. Mark Twain put it this way, kindness is a language which the deaf can hear and the blind can see. Humility and kindness are virtues by definition. A Christian poet named Aurelius Prudentius came up with a list of seven heavenly virtues 1600 years ago. Those virtues are chastity, temperance, charity, diligence, patience, humility, and kindness. They say that giving a speech, you should only give your audience two or three things to remember. So I'm going to focus on the last two of those heavenly virtues. Two behaviors that I know for a fact will benefit you as you continue your education, enter the workforce, and more importantly, just live your lives. Let's take a look at what I think it means to be humble and kind, and what humility looks like to those around you who are reviewing the lyrics of a song. You know, there's a light that glows by the front door. Don't forget the keys under your mat. Childhood star shine. Always be humble and kind. Go to church because your mama says to. Visit ground every chance that you can. It won't be a waste of time. Always stay humble and kind. Don't expect a free ride from no one. Don't hold a grudge or a gift, and here's why. Bitterness keeps you from flying. Always stay humble and kind. Know the difference between sleeping with someone and sleeping with someone you love. I love you ain't no pickup line, so always stay humble and kind. When it's hot, eat a root beer popsicle. Turn off the AC and roll the windows down. Let that summer sunshine. Always stay humble and kind. Don't take for granted the love this life gives you. When you get to where you're going, don't forget to turn back around. Help the next one in line. Always stay humble and kind. Hold the door. Say please. Say thank you. Don't steal. Don't cheat. And don't lie. I know you got mountains to climb, but always stay humble and kind. When those dreams you're dreaming come to you, when the work you put in is realized, let yourself feel the pride, but always stay humble and kind. Graduates, the message I'm delivering this evening is clear and simple. The world's full of lies. Lies like, you can have it all. Character doesn't matter. Money, fame, or physical beauty will make you happy. The truth in the end, and what is really important, is who you were and what you did to have a positive impact on those around you. Being humble and kind is a message the world desperately needs right now. With that said, I'd like to acknowledge the incredible parents of our students. Way to go. You've done an outstanding job. Your tireless dedication, your love, your support, and most of all, the attention you paid to shaping your children's character. I've been blessed with the opportunity to work with students from all over the state and nation. I can say without hesitation, the young people I've worked with here in Galena are some of the most humble and kind people I've ever met. And that didn't just happen by accident. Class of 2018, I challenge you to go climb your mountains. Do not expect a free ride, but put in the work so you can realize those dreams you have for yourselves. Remember to say please and thank you, because it's the right thing to do. And if a person truly doesn't deserve the courtesy, then it's like heaping burning coals on their head, and that can be pretty entertaining to watch. Learn to forgive. Don't let anger and resentment influence the path you choose, because that trail is poorly marked and only leads to disillusionment and pain. Don't confuse lust with love. Take time to listen to your elders, even though right now you probably feel like you have the world by the tail. A little further down the line, you will probably discover they actually really knew what they were talking about. Maybe just a little bit smarter than you think they are right now. As you pursue and achieve your goals, go out of your way to help others reach theirs. Oh, and don't forget to eat that popsicle. Because, let's face it, when it's hot outside, a popsicle just tastes darn good. Graduates, I am honored that you trusted me to teach you, and more importantly, learn from you. Let yourself feel a pride, and know that you're already well on your way to becoming the men and women I would be proud, and I use that word carefully, to call my friends. As you set out into the world, don't let your aims and ambitions blind you to the importance of character and service to others. Stay grounded in family and religion, live honestly, work hard, respect your elders, remain humble, and make kindness a habit. I'd like to end this address by leaving you with a couple of thoughts. First, never, never forget each of you is an incredible work of art, and you are signed by the hand of God. Second, you probably will never have more energy or enthusiasm, hair or brain cells, I can vouch for those last two, than you have today. So use what God has given you wisely. Make the world a better place for yourself and those around you. God bless. Godspeed. Good luck, my friends.